Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Excel video for you with separating date and time when they're together in one cell. Let's dive into this right now. So over in column A, I put in some dates and times. And then in column B, I put in the date. Column C is the time. And over in column D, I've got revenue. The issue is I actually want to separate the date from the time. This happens a lot with booking or scheduling software. I know that Microsoft Bookings does this. I get data like this all the time. So method one to separate the date and time is I'm going to go over into cell B2 and I'm going to just start typing in that first date. I'm going to type in the second date and I'm going to use Microsoft Excel's Flash Fill, which is one of my favorite features. If you go to the data tab and over here is Flash Fill, the keyboard shortcut is Control and the letter E. It's even showing you that here. So I'm going to just do Control E right here and they're correct. I just checked those. So I had to use Flash Fill to put in the date and therefore I'm going to use Flash Fill to put in the time 1:40 p.m., 10 a.m., Control E. In case you're wondering, when I do flash fill, I usually, if it doesn't pick up automatically, which it will a lot of times, if it picks up automatically, you just press enter. But it doesn't, so I usually do at least two or three to help Excel recognize the pattern that I'm doing. I have a ton of videos on flash fill, including advanced flash fill. I'll put a link to every one of those down below and I'll throw one up in the top left also right now. So there's method one. Another way you could handle this, by the way, and those all came out correctly with flash fill, there is an Excel function that I love. It is the integer function, INT. So I'm gonna come over here and just type in 375.25. I'm making up numbers. They just need to be decimals. One more, 6,000.45. Good. So an integer is a whole number. So 375.25 is 375 and the fraction would be 1/4. And there's the decimal. You're already looking at it. So equals INT. And there's the definition, rounds a number down to the nearest integer. What number? F4. I should get just 375 here. And just to prove this, I'm going to go to the Home tab and hit the comma to show you that I got 0.00. There you go with the integer. And it did round down, by the way. That 400 is 400, not 400, 401. So now that we know what the integer function does, dates and times, I feel like I've said this like 100 times. Let me get rid of that. Here's some tips about dates. I'm going to just copy these. I'm going to just put in some dates real quick over here, just a couple. Control semicolon puts in the current date. Today is the 12th. That was control semicolon. And I'm also going to do 1/1/1900 and one more date, 12/31/2024. Copy these, paste them. I'm going to go make them comma style and I'm going to lose the decimals. Dates are numbers. They had to decide when in Excel to start counting, and they decided to start counting on 1/1/1900 is the number one, as you can see on my screen. So today's date is the 12th, and there is 44,724. That's what allows you to subtract one date from another date, in case you're wondering. There you go. So now that I know that dates are numbers, equals INT, I'm going to use the integer function on this date and time. Cool? How about that? If you do equals INT and you click on the date and it's got date and time, it may come over like that, 44,713. But I just explained it. Dates are numbers, so just go make it whatever date format you want to in the number group. I'm going to go a short date. Autofill down. The advantage of using INT over flash fill, or maybe consider disadvantage, there's now a function in column B. which is great if I put in the wrong date. Notice I got the first here, but actually that's supposed to be the 5th. It updates with the INT function. Flashfill would have left that as 6/1/2022. So you just have to decide which way you're going with this. I use both, by the way. So now to figure out the time, guess what? I'm going to do equals A2 because that's got the date and the time in it. I meant to show you this. Equals that. This should have definitely for sure if I make this numbers. Look, it's going to have a decimal place. Whenever you got date and time, you're going to have a decimal. Unless it would be 12 a.m., then it would be 0.00. Come back to that in just a second. So equals A2 minus the integer of A2. Yes, I do want to do it. How about that? Again, compared to flash fill, this one will change if I change one of these times over here. This was 3:40 p.m. and it's 3:40 p.m. in cell C2. All right, another way. I don't care about flash fill. I don't care about integer because someone asked me, they want to know what is the revenue for each day or each day and year. It doesn't matter. Well, they happen to all be 2022, so each day would work. They want to know what's the revenue. I would first, act like I don't have this. I'm actually going to delete this right here. Gone. I would first click in here and use control in the letter A just to make sure I've got my range. Notice it's all connected. If I did control A and got just this, it's not picking up the revenue. That's my issue. But since control A got the revenue, I'm good. If your data goes way across over to the right, you're going to do control A and then control period. I'm holding down control and I keep pressing the period and it moves me around the corners. So that is how if this data went over into column C, Z or something, I would do control A, control period. There you go. Back to my point. They just want to know what's the revenue for each day. Well, that sounds like a pivot table to me. Insert pivot table. I usually put my pivot tables on a new sheet, but I'm going to do it right here, existing sheet. And I'm even going to throw it right here in cell F8. Click OK. My header row is going up and down now. Watch this. Act like date and time are here, but date by itself is not, and neither is time. I'm going to just drag date and time here. Watch what it does. Revenue down to the values. So I've got my total for June and I've got my total for August. But I want to know the total for each date. Click on one of your days. So click on June or August. If you're over here on one of the numbers, it won't work. Notice the group is grayed out. Click on a date, ungroup, group selection. Let's do months and days because it's all 2022 in this example. But notice there is your hours, minutes, and seconds, but I don't need them. So when I hit OK, perfect. For June, 550. For August, 120. You can come in here and collapse them. You can collapse them all at one time. So it all depends on exactly what you want to do with these. I would have used flash fill or INT if I needed to come in here and do some detailed sorting. If I just want to sum them up, I'm probably just going to throw them into a pivot table. That is all I have today. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. I appreciate your time. Any comments, post them below. Have a great day. Thank you.